special presentation.
He's logged 8 consecutive top 5 country singles, a streak that has included 5 number ones, 3 consecutive number one music videos. He's broken industry records, sold millions, played sold-out critically acclaimed concerts to thousands across the country, and that's just for starters. For the next hour, we'll take you from the outback of Australia to the top of the American music charts with Keith Urban, The Road to Be Here. From his early days with The Ranch to his multi-platinum award-winning solo career, from the intimate moments of creation to electrified performances, it's Keith Urban, The Road to Be Here, a musical journey of music's brightest shooting star.
Right now, this is it. These are the days. Life's happening. It's all happening. It's right now. The real voyage of discovery is not in seeking new landscapes, but having new eyes. And I'm trying daily to look around and see how wonderful it is. I play all the time. And to me, I play on stage. I feel like a kid in his first garage band. It's a really an amazing thing, you know. And this, I still go to some of the gigs and look up at the stage and all the equipment and stuff. Like, cool, you know. It's so weird. I've been doing it forever, and it's just exciting. It's in some ways more exciting now than ever before. Let's see some hands in the air. Nice. Look, come on. It's like air to me. It's like breathing. It's just something that. I not only want to do, but I have to do it. It also just naturally happens every single day.
Awesome. He is a great singer and a great guitar player. Please make welcome Keith Urban.
Days go by. Keith's debut single from his latest album, Be Here, has gotten him to the top of the charts yet again. But his success never grows old. Every day that a talent like Keith comes along, and dealing with his success can be a delicate balancing act between acceptance and humility.
Right now, where I am at in my life, it's for me, it's a case of learning to accept who I am and what I do. I don't think of it so much as in the limitations, but the area that I naturally am within, musically, songs that naturally come out, songs that I naturally gravitate towards, and being all right with that. And I think I have the ability to express some of the things that I'm trying to express in my playing, and that's really all I've ever wanted to do.
Let's see some hands in the air, folks.
But when you're number one, there's a lot more to do, and music videos go with the territory. Having charted several number one music videos, Keith worked hard to make sure that the video for Days Go By would capture the message of the song. The look, the feel, and the production were to be a part of his evolution.
Here we go! Round playback!
Everything in and it's all backwards.
With veteran director Wayne Isham at the helm, the day begins with a very complicated special effects shot. In order to achieve the desired effect, Keith had to do everything in reverse. According to Keith, the most challenging part of this setup was learning to sing his song backwards.
It's like a speaking in tongues.
Filmed at normal speed, Keith had to move against the grain as the extras rushed past. In post-production, the footage is reversed for some mind-blowing ultra-reality.
Go, go, go! Come on! Get ready!
I wish I could get more committed to just throwing this thing. I like this guitar.
One of the trickier shots was when Keith had to throw his guitar out of frame and into the hands of an agile crew member. As the shot rolls forward, the guitar comes flying into Keith's hands as he rocks his way through the crowd. Shot on location in Los Angeles, the shoot was highlighted by a well-timed visit from Keith's number one fan.
Happy birthday to you.
Keith's mom was in town from Australia to make sure her son was behaving.
Oh, Keith, don't do that.
She's taking a whole bunch of pictures, and she's phoning my family back in Australia and giving them a play-by-play of what's happening. She's good. She's just a great hang. She's always upbeat, and I'm really blessed to have her here at this time in my life, especially.
Turn. It's back to Keith's early days growing up in Australia when the road to be here continued. We're back with Keith Urban, the road to be here. Keith Urban's passion for the country sound was born in another country, way down under, Nashville. His musical tastes were formed in his native Australia, where he grew up in a family of four and was the child of supportive parents who surrounded him with music.
I guess I was about four, and my parents bought me this little ukulele, and apparently I could strum it in time to the songs on the radio and keep the rhythm. So my dad thought, well, that's good, he's got rhythm. If we can get him to learn some chords, you know, maybe this rhythm, this racket will become some music. So when I was six, they bought me a guitar, my first guitar.
We had a small store, and a lady came into the store one day and she said that she was a teacher, a guitar teacher. She'd like to put an ad in the window, and we said, yeah, but there's one condition, that you teach our son to play the guitar. And she said, okay. So that was, he was six and a half, and we got him a three-quarter size guitar, which even at his age, he was only a little fella for six, and it was big on him then. He was in his first talent quest, I think, when he was seven and a half. And I think he got an award for the best dress or something like that. We always made sure he was well-dressed.
We're a pretty tight family growing up. It was only me and my brother. So, relatively tight family. But I moved away from home at 15 and spent so many years away from home, and then moved to the States 12 years ago. It takes a lot of work to get your career up and running in the States. Perhaps not as much now as before, I don't know, but certainly when I came over 10, 12 years ago, you just gotta be here in Nashville. You gotta dig in and commit and stay, and that means not leaving.
It was a journey born from passion, purpose, and persistence that moved his first band, The Ranch, into the Nashville skyline.
Walk in the country with me.
The Ranch came about because I couldn't bring my five-piece group from Australia to America. I just couldn't afford it. So the minimum I could bring, I figured, given that I play guitar and sing, would be like the bass player and the drummer. So let's start there. The unfortunate part was I had a five-piece band in Australia, and the bass player and drummer didn't sing. I had a rhythm guitar player and a keyboard player. They were my two harmony singers. So I was faced with the reality of having a three-piece band with no singers in it except me.
Walk in the country with me. Watch the sun sink down on the trees. Do us some good to get down in the woods. Take a little walk in the country with me.
I needed to keep it three-piece for economic reasons. So our bass player left and I got a singing bass player. And so really, and that's, The Ranch was born out of economics and in the end became this sort of unique three-piece thing. That most of the time was probably more frustrating for me as a guitar player, because you gotta play so much. And it just got a little draining for me after a while. But I will say I learned a lot about diversifying my playing and there's, you can't slack off in a three-piece group. You really, you got to pull your weight. So in hindsight, it was a good time for me musically.
Even though he received Grammy consideration for the Ranch's instrumental song, Clutterbilly, things were starting to change.
I have such sometimes mixed feelings about the group. I got to the point where I didn't even feel like I could trust anybody's opinion. Everybody had different agendas, and, you know, I got a sense from my own spiritual center of what I had to do, but I just didn't have the strength to do it. It was really hard. And in the end, I just knew that it was done, it was over.
Although the Ranch was over, it was really the beginning for Keith Urban. Soon after the fallout with The Ranch came the release of his first solo album. Blessed with the gift of your love. It became quickly evident that his star was on the rise. His initial single release shot him up to the top of the music charts for the first time, and there it rested comfortably at number one for several weeks. His solo success was now a reality, but he still struggled with his ability to accept his professional success. His thinking had to change and adjust to this newfound celebrity.
One of the great paradoxes is that in order to change, you must fully get comfortable with yourself and fully accept yourself, you know? It's very true as an artist, too. I think you struggle constantly with understanding the area that you really are just naturally yourself. I think it's a combination of getting more comfortable with myself as a person and as a musician, and you just, this is the stuff you really are good at because it's natural, and yes, you can do a bit of this, you can do a bit of that, but you really, this is where you should be, this is what you do best, and the struggle between being comfortable with that but also being frustrated with that so that you continue to push it out a little bit further into new comfortable areas.
By pushing himself to even greater emotional depth and challenge, Keith put together his second album, Golden Road, which was a revealing collection that included the record-breaking number one first single, Somebody Like You. Three singles followed, including two number ones, with the album eventually going to double platinum. And 100 weeks later, it remained in the top 10. Keith Urban was now a force to be reckoned with. He was a bona fide multi-platinum award-winning singer, songwriter, and performer of extraordinary measure.
I got no money in my pockets. I got a hole in my jeans. I had a job and I lost it. But it won't get to me, 'cause I'm riding with my baby. It's a brand new day. We're on the wheels of an angel, flying away. And the sun. Georgia to Tennessee.
I don't feel at the top of the game by a long stretch. To me, the guitar gods are the Duane Allmans and the Hendrix and the Stevie Ray Vaughans and really Robert Johnson. I mean, these guys that redefine the way we listen to guitar, to me, are the true heroes of it. But I've always loved playing as an expression of the things that I can't quite put into words. It's a wonderful language all to itself. It's kind of a Zen thing. Feel like a conduit on the really good nights. You've got to sort of put that in perspective, or it can be really, you know, dangerous.
And now the success from Golden Road paved his path to Be Here. Come back, more from Keith Urban, from the studio, into his soul and back to the audience, when the road to Be Here continues. For his latest album, Be Here, Keith pushed his songwriting into deeper musical and emotional territory. He reunited with co-producer Dan Huff, and work began on the follow-up to Golden Road.
Oh, lights, camera, action.
Just be yourself, even if it's somebody else.
I was bound to be screwed with my singing style from hearing Creedence, I think, because, you know, big wheels keep on turning, like turning, what's
turning,
it? Turning.
Yeah.
But I sang it like that. Mary keeps on boining, what that?
Boining, yeah, what was that?
It's just great, man, I love it.
Hello, Dan.
You're not listening to your son playing guitar on your shot. You're sick of that stuff.
No.
I've heard it all before.
I never get sick of it. I can sit here all day and listen.
But got things to do.
Yeah, but I have to. I've places to go, people to see, money to spend.
That's right. Writing for me is really mysterious and difficult and challenging in every other way. I don't feel like a born-to-be writer, you know, in the vein of the greats, in my opinion. But that's why I love co-writing. I think there's a strength to be brought when you have two people come together that excel in specific areas. You know, has there ever been a song called You're My Better Half? And I mean, not that I know of, but it seems to be an obvious thing to write about. Everyone seems to have one, so in some way. Thank you.
the sun is shining on down in Tennessee.
I mean, Making Golden Road was pretty loose, but this one was really loose in the sense of just, man, we, in the course of a day, we'd probably only work a handful of hours, and then the rest was just shooting the breeze and drinking coffee and hanging out. And I think it's a really important part for me of keeping the whole thing loose and candid and effortless too, you know.
You can join in on this anytime.
Sure you can.
That's
pretty good.
Yeah, they're there. Get you?
There you go. Okay, good. It's loose for you. Got you. It's Leanne, right? The goosebump test worked.
Excellent.
End of the chorus, right? And right the last line?
Yeah. Boom.
That's a window to do. Oh, my. Thank you for coming. Come again.
This is so big.
How do you do this? Don't you miss doing this?
Yeah.
Too busy doing this. Yeah, it windmills.
You can use that lick and then get into the other set.
That's funny. That's funny stuff.
No wonder it's impossible to live with this.
When you get comfortable in the studio, I think you then tend to feel more comfortable with showing more of yourself and actually forgetting you're making a record. I think that's the most important thing, to get in the studio and just... It's a musical diary, and you just pour it out. You know, there's just you and the engineer, maybe, and perhaps the co-producer or somebody, but intimate, small group, and pour it out. And just, you know, I don't think about the fact that a bunch of people are going to hear it when I'm recording it. I just think about getting it down and being truthful, making memories of us. It had already been recorded, but strange enough, apparently without the bridge. And I didn't know too much about the history of the song, and they sent me this copy, and I thought it was most beautiful. I think one of the most beautiful lyrics I've ever heard in its simplicity, in saying things that you just wonder why they've never been said that way before in a song.
And I want to sleep with you forever. I want to die in your arms. In a cabin by a meadow. And I'm gonna love you like nobody loves you. And I love your trust-making memories of us.
When we come back, making more memories with Keith Urban in the studio, when the road to Be Here continues. We're back with Keith Urban.
As far as I'm concerned, there is an absolute level of honesty in my records that are inherent by the fact that I do some goofy songs as well, you know?
Everybody wants Kung Fu, baby. I thought it was faster than lightning.
Sometimes you think, well, man, that's not a very cool song. That's not cool, and it's not this and that, but... You know, it's just, you got to be who you are, and I got a real geek, nerdy side, and, you know.
Yeah, really. Sounds bizarre without the drums, I know. And capo.
It's a program of rigorous honesty. You know, country music's origins are all Irish music, and then going way back there.
Someday, baby, you and I are gonna be the ones. So hold on.
Days Goodbye did start as a guitar riff, like a lot of the stuff does. And there's a sort of a Celtic overtone, I think, an almost an Irish kind of jig type thing to some of the music. I have no idea where that stuff comes from.
The days that have gone by for Keith Urban have not all been easily met with success. In spite of his love for music, his struggles with life at times led him down a different path. He worked hard to overcome the demons of life on stage and off.
I wrote Tonight I Wanna Cry about maybe 2 or 3 years ago. I dabbled a little bit on piano, quite badly, but enough to not get in the way of songwriting. Sometimes can do that.
That sounds nice there. That's like an old vinyl record. Yes, everything. Yeah, it's perfect. It's excellent. I like it. Let's go.
Alone in this house again tonight. I got the TV on, the sound turned down, and a bottle of wine. There's pictures of you and I on the walls around me, the way that it was and could have been surrounded.
The lyric came really fast. I think it was being in that boy, just drawing on that place where you've had a relationship just collapse and you're on your own. And you've kept stuff inside for so long, and some people don't know how to cry. They don't know how to. They've just never been let cry, and they've never been encouraged to, and never been comfortable with it. And I've never been that kind of person. I'm very sensitive, and I cry the drop of a hat on a lot of stuff. But I know a lot of people that struggle with it. I'd gone through some addiction stuff. And I really lost myself for a long time there, because playing is who I am, and when you take the stage away and take that forum away, and I'm left here as just civilian Keith, I didn't know that guy at all, didn't particularly care for him. So I had to learn to really find out who I was, who I really was without the guitar and everything else.
And there's no
you just got to stand by and hope that they get through it all right. And a lot of it is a growing up process, which they have to do by themselves.
Don't you know, nobody drinks alone.
There are times when you really want to reach out to them, and you do as much as you can, and then it's up to them.
Your past,
And now, recovered from his past abuses, Keith has taken on a new outlook on life. One that deals with things as they come. One that deals with them in the moment.
You remember whiskey on your daddy's bread.
I don't want to repeat a lot of the same things, and God knows that's what'll happen if I don't grow from it and learn from it.
And you scared your little brother half to death.
Being that guy in the song, Nobody Drinks Alone, just being, from being in that place. And I like the parables in the song, that it's not necessarily just about drinking, it's about just being accountable for your actions in this life. Times when you just think, oh, I don't want to cry anymore. I'm so sick of it. It's wrecking my eyes and it's just ruining myself. And, you know, it's such an intensity sometimes being hurt. But if you don't continue to keep yourself open towards it, you also don't keep yourself open to potential bliss and peace and serenity and real love. That's the risk you take.
There's some nights when it's a little more fluid than others. Yeah. When stuff comes out that you've never played before, and you're looking down, and going, "Wow, that was good."
How can I remember that?
Well, yeah. And then the problem is you then try and do it the next night because you go, "Yeah, that I'm going to do that again," and because it's not the same because. I read this quote one time about the only real music, the only true music, is when a baby first cries. After that, the baby knows the mum will come running, so it's all show business.
Yeah.
It's so truthful.
Okay. It's a feeling you just hang.
There's a challenge in also making the sort of, you know, rehearsed spontaneity happen as well and make it look natural. But the stuff that comes out from just constant repetition can be just amazing. The boredom just sends you off into another area that, you know. I found that recording a lot with Dan, that he would have me do stuff over and over and over again. It would drive me insane. But you know, and after a while, you just end up working up here somewhere and go off somewhere else just from sheer frustration, and you end up with something that, you know, becomes a signature riff earlier on in the song, which happened on Somebody Like You, the thing, which came the end riffs that happened in the middle of the solo originally, because I was doing the solo, and I figured I had the solo was right, it was structured, it was right, and so Dan would just have me doing it over and over again. It was driving me insane. And after a while, I just ended up going somewhere else just because I was so bored. Just a guy that loves playing music.
Keith Urban, the road to be here continues. We're back with Keith Urban, the road to be here.
Oh.
Keith Urban, the emotion captured in the studio translates perfectly to the stage, where his performances are soulful, passionate, and highly contagious.
When you walked up behind me and covered my eyes and whispered in my ear, guess who?
Pacing is a hard thing to do when there's such a natural rush from the crowd. But that's the trick, is in pacing yourself and staying focused on the job.
There's a real simplicity to a lot of what I do and the way I think, and then there's a real complexity as well.
It's a real thing to walk out on stage, but at the same time, hell man, it's a rush. It's very hard to have a balanced life when it's all about the stage, and so I've had to learn to, be cool with me and be all right with me and all my little or big grand flaws and all my humanisms. It's very fragile, and also it was the sort of cold reality of going, man, I've got to really dig being around me and be okay with me off stage. You know, I've spent all of my life playing on stage, and it's where I'm most comfortable, but it's not a healthy thing. It's not a good way to live.
In fact, I'll feel a whole lot better. I bet you think of me. So take your records, take your freedom, take your memories, I don't need them. Take your space and your stupid reasons.
If it was a theme, it was just it's like anybody else. You know, what are we doing here? What's life about?
We think about tomorrow, then it slips away. Oh yes, it does. We talk about forever, but we've only got today. And the days go by. I can feel them flying like a hand out the window as the cars go by. It's all we've been given, so you better start living. You better start living. Better start living right now. As days go by.
Seems to be a more evident future now, with the man and the music in sync, where a professional and emotional maturity have melded into a clear direction. Consistency, honesty, and integrity are the ingredients that now seem to give him balance. And by putting one step in front of the other and keeping the faith, the results are sure to take care of themselves.
Any regrets?
Always got some of those, but they mostly give way to understanding that everything is part of where you end up. I'm grateful for where I am right now. And a lot of things got me here. There's some things that you lose along the way that take a while to come to terms with. But it's a long road too, and you just never know what God's got in store.